Welcome back to CPAPHelpDesk.com. In this video, we're going to review the strength and weaknesses of this mask called the FitLife Full Face Mask made by Respironics. Now, personally speaking, I haven't had much success with this mask. I only have one person that I have been able to help out recommended this, and it has worked out. Generally, somebody going for this should first go through all other types of full face masks before leaning into this. That's just my professional opinion. A full face mask, even like this. This is a great full face mask called the Hans Rudolph V2, or this, a hybrid. After going through the entire variety of full face masks and hybrids, if that doesn't work out, That's when I bring this out and recommend this. Okay, this is more of a last resort, and that's just my opinion. This is good for mouth breathers. This is good for somebody who's having really high CPAP and Bipap pressures. This works really good for back sleepers. Somebody who has a lot of facial hair, this works well. Side sleepers, it is not effective. You will experience a lot of leaks. Stomach sleepers, yes, it works good. Do not try to use this mask and try to read in bed or watch TV. It will affect your eyes, make it irritated. Claustrophobia, what do you think? If you're suffering from claustrophobia, maybe this is definitely not the mask for you. This is not good for a person who's active in bed, who tends to roll around, move around in bed a lot. This is not good. Ironically, this mask is appropriate for pediatrics. The small size mask of this, okay, this comes in small and large. The small size mask is good for someone as young as 7 years long, 7 years old, just as long as they weigh at least 40 pounds or 20 kilograms and higher. Now, for adults, you could use this or large. The large, what the manufacturer is saying, it fits most people. You must weigh at least 66 pounds or 30 kilograms. Okay? Now, go visit the website. There is about 9 possible side effects that you should look out for. If you use this mask, I will list them out. It'll take too long. The headgear. I want to go over the features of this. The headgear. You have a strap right here on the top, here and here. Okay. The headgear comes in small and large. They have a thing here called the quick disconnect clip. Is really good. It's very easy to take it off. I'll show it to you. You do this if in the middle of the night you need to get up to use the bathroom. That's it. And then you can easily clip it off. I'm going to leave it unclipped because I'm going to take this off to show you the inside of it in a moment. This is a good feature. This is a very good feature. The elbow rotates 360 degrees, which is good. So this way you can move the tubing out of your way. You're not being tangled up in it when you move from left to right. It also helps reduce episodes of leak. Depending on where your tubing is and how the tubing is laid, you can actually pull the mask slightly off your face and create leaks. Okay. The exhalation port is actually here. This is how, when you exhale, you see these things? This is the vents for where it escapes. It is kind of quiet. It's a pretty unique design for Respironics in this sense. Once again, I haven't had much experience, so I don't know how the bed partners feel about it. Do they actually feel the air coming out and hitting them? Okay, I only have one person who absolutely loves it. Everybody else, as a last resort, when I've introduced this, dislikes it. In the bottom here, I'm going to zoom in a little bit more. Here we go. This here is the O2 port where you can connect oxygen tubing in here, if you need oxygen, we connect oxygen through here. In hospitals, we also measure what the pressure is in the mask by putting a special tubing in here. This round opening here is the anti-asphyxia valve, meaning if you have a power failure, yes, you will be able to breathe through here, but it will be very uncomfortable. And for most people, they'll feel it. When the power goes out, you'll feel very uncomfortable in your breathing, and you'll end up pulling the mask off your face. Let me quickly go into the other parts here. Oh, before I do, I want to show you, you know what? The biggest source of leak is right here. Can you see? It's not really, let me zoom in properly. Okay. Right in here. This is where the biggest source of leak is. It doesn't really do a good job sealing here. I even experienced that when I tried it out. The other thing is the cushion is not altogether comfortable for everyone. Even though it feels kind of soft, but for some people it really does sort of bruise them. In fact, if you read the literature that comes with it, they tell you to soak this thing in soapy water for 30 to 60 minutes if you have a sensitive skin, so you can soften this cushion up, the silicone cushion up a little better. Okay. The other problem here is drooling, because remember, this covers the nose and mouth. Okay. You see where the mouth is, where my finger is? I don't know if you can see it right through there. The mask comes up to here. If you're someone who drools a lot, that can pose a little bit of an uncomfortable issue for you. Personally speaking, I've tried it out for 2 nights and my eyes were affected. They were drying out so quickly, within minutes. I felt it uncomfortable. I've had maybe 2 or 3 other patients throughout the year since this mask has come out has complained about that issue. And finally, one other negative that I experienced with this was, and I actually have had, I forget now, 1 or 2 other people mentioned it to me, you can actually hear yourself breathing in and out with this mask. You go, you can sort of, I could hear it. So that was kind of hard for me to fall asleep with that in mind. Stop by my website, please. I think you can find a lot of good, useful information in there. And till the next time I see you, I'm wishing you sweet dreams.